मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर स्टडिंग रिगार्डिंग द टेस्ट फॉर एडिक्वेसी ऑफ इंडेक्स नंबर इन विच वी हैड लर्न्ड अबाउट यूनिट टेस्ट एंड टाइम रिवर्सल टेस्ट टुडे विल बी लर्निंग रिगार्डिंग द फैक्टर रिवर्सल टेस्ट द थर्ड मेथड अंडर द टेस्ट फॉर एडिक्वेसी ऑफ इंडेक्स नंबर इन फैक्टर रिवर्सल टेस्ट whenever the price index number and the quantity index number is multiplied or the product of price index number and the quantity index number is the value index number in other words it means that factor reversal test means that the changes in the price multiplied by the changes in the quantity should be equal to the changes in the value so the total change in the price multiplied by total change in the quantity should be equal to the total change in the value in terms of symbol if we write the change is nothing but the index number so price index number is denoted by P01 multiplied by so multiplied by we have change in the quantity so change in the quantity is the quantity index number which is denoted by Q01 should be equal so equal to the total change in value so the value total change in value is the value index number which is denoted by V01 or we can write it as P01 into Q01 equals we'll write the V01 formula sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q0 again here the price index number quantity index number and value index number it is only the ratios we are not representing that in terms of percentages so into 100 is not taken it is without the constant of proportionality so now we'll check for each and every method which satisfies the factor reversal test so we'll begin with the last year's price index number so last year's price index number formula is sigma P1 Q0 divided by sigma P0 Q0 you can write it as interchange P and Q so in the time reversal test we were interchanging the time that is 0 and 1 base year and current year was changing here we are interchanging the price and the quantity we can write it like this or directly if you remember the formula of last year's quantity index number you can mention that what is last year's quantity index number the sigma q1 p0 divided by sigma q0 p0 we can check here so p should be interchanged with q so you'll get q1 P0 that is what I have written in the numerator and in the denominator sigma again P is interchanged with Q and Q is interchanged with P so we'll get Q0 P0 when we have the last year's price index and the quantity index we have to multiply and check whether it is equal to the value index number so before that we'll write the condition FRT condition is P01 into Q01 equals sigma P1 Q1 sigma P0 Q0 this condition is very important it carries one mark so if they have asked time reversal test or factor reversal test to prove that then without the condition don't solve it the condition carries one mark so we'll multiply now P01L into P10L so last year's price index number and the quantity index number P01L into Q01L is sigma P1 Q0 divided by sigma P0 Q0 so this is regarding the last year's price index number into we have to write the quantity index number of last year's which is sigma Q1 P0 divided by sigma Q0 P0 and it will never be equal to sigma P1 Q1 because we doesn't have P1 Q1 in the last year's price index number. So it is not equal to the value index number. Last year's price and quantity, if we are multiplying, then we doesn't get equal to the value index number. So therefore, last year's price index number, last year's index number does not satisfy factor reversal test. Similarly, you can prove it for other methods. Pasche's, Marshall Edwards, Darbish Bowley, and Cayley's index number. All these methods will not satisfy factor reversal test. So it doesn't satisfy factor reversal test. If you want, you can practice it like this itself. Take P01 formula, that is Pasche's, Marshall Edwards, Darbish Bowley and Cayley's method. Check for each and everything. You have to take that particular index number formula, price index, then quantity index, and it will not be equal to P1 Q1 and P0 Q0. Fisher's index number will satisfy factor reversal test. We'll be proving that now. Only the Fisher's index number will satisfy factor reversal test. It doesn't satisfy by any other methods. You can write it directly. It does not satisfy it. Now we'll be proving it for Fisher's. So Fisher's price index number is P01F equals square root of sigma P1 Q0 divided by sigma P0 Q0 into sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q1. Now interchange P and Q, will get the quantity index number of Fisher's. So Q01F is square root of sigma Q1 P0 divided by sigma Q0 P0 into sigma Q1 P1 divided by sigma Q0 P1. Now write the condition of factor reversal test, which is P01 into Q01 equals sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q0. Now take the left hand side, we'll get P01F into Q01F. Then substitute the particular values of this. And since we have square root in both price index and quantity index number, I'll be mentioning it square root only once. So it will be square root of sigma P1 Q0, and I'm writing the price index number formula first. So it is sigma P1 Q0 divided by sigma P0 Q0 into sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q1. So this is regarding the price index. Then we have to write the quantity index number of Fisher's, which is sigma Q1 P0 divided by sigma Q0 P0 into sigma Q1 P1 divided by sigma Q0 P1. Now we have P1 Q0 in the numerator and Q0 P1, it is in the other side. in the reverse order. So read it like this: P1 Q0 we have in the denominator, P1 Q0 in the numerator. So it will get cancelled. The next term P1 Q1, again we have P1 Q1 in the numerator itself, so it doesn't get cancelled. Then see the next term, P0 Q0, we have one more P0 Q0 and both are in terms of denominator, so it won't get cancelled. And the last term is P0 Q1. P0 Q1, one is in terms of denominator, the other one in the numerator, so we can cancel that. The remaining term is sigma P1 Q1 and sigma P0 Q0. Square root is there and there is two times which is repeated this, so we can write it as square. Square and square root will get cancelled. We'll be remaining with sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q0. This is what we have to prove it. P01F into Q01F equals sigma P1 Q1 divided by sigma P0 Q0. Or when we multiply the price and the quantity index number, it is equal to value index number. So we have proved it for the Fisher's index number. Only because of this condition, and since both price and quantities are used, Fisher's index number is called ideal index number. Among all the index number, Fisher's is only index number which satisfies time reversal test and factor reversal test. So this is regarding the factor reversal test. The next method under the test for adequacy of index number is circular test. And this factor reversal test was again given by Irving Fisher itself. And the circular test, first it was suggested by Westergaard. And this is the continuation or extension of time reversal test. Circular test is the extension of time reversal test. It is extended for more than two periods. In the time reversal test, we were taking only the base year and current year. So in the circular test, it is considered for more than two periods. So it is extension of time reversal test for more than two periods. And every time the base period will be shifting, it won't be same. For example, if we have three periods, so 0, 1 and 2, then it will be P01. So first we are taking 0 and 1 as the base year and current year into P12. Next, price index number is based on the 1 and 2 periods into P20. So it is running under the circular manner. So first 0, 1, then 1 and 2, then 2 and 0. It runs under the circular method. So the name circular test. So P01 into P12 into P20 equals 1. So every time the base year and current year it is changing, it is not the same thing. That is what circular test specifies. So it is an extension of time reversal test for more than two periods. And when we have three periods, the condition will be like this. If we have four periods, zero, one, two and three, then the condition will be P01. So first 0 and 1, then we have to take P12, next P23, then again to the first base itself, P30 equals 1. So this can be continued for many periods. periods. And this test is satisfied only by simple geometric mean. Weight method. This is asked many times. Name the index number which satisfies circular test. They won't ask the definition. It is only name the index number which satisfies circular test. It is simple geometric mean and Cayley's fixed weight method. And sometimes the condition can be asked. When the condition is asked, you have to mention the periods, whether you are doing it for 3 periods or 4 periods. If it is 2 periods, then it becomes time reversal test. So here it is only for more than 2 periods. So you can take any period, whichever you like, then show it for that. It is equal to 1. So this is regarding the test for adequacy of index numbers, where we have learned all the methods and which method satisfies, which method does not satisfy index particular test. So it is asked always in 1 mark, name the index number which satisfies either the unit test, circular test, time reversal test and factor reversal test. And you have to also remember which does not satisfy: unit test, time reversal test, factor reversal test and circular test. After this we have one more topic called as bias in an index number. So bias is nothing but error. So bias in an index number, Laspierre's index number shows upward bias. And Paget's index number shows downward bias. So it is asked in 1 mark, which index number shows upward bias? The answer is Laspierre's index number. Name the index number which shows downward bias. The answer is Paget's index number. And name the index number which is free of bias. Then you can write Marshall Edward, Darbish Bowley and Fisher's index number. And these 3 methods are free of bias because it considers both price, both base year and current year price and quantities. Here in Laspierre and Paget's, it takes only one. When we are considering Laspierre's price index number, only Q0 is taken here. Q1 is not taken into consideration. And even in the Paget's index number, Q1 is taken as weight. So current year quantity is taken, base year quantity is not taken into consideration. Because of that we have bias in these 2 methods. So Laspierre's index number shows the upward bias because it is taking the base year quantity, which gives greater weightage to Q0, to the quantity. And here in the Paget's price index number, it shows downward bias since it is considering current year quantity. So it is asked in 1 mark or in 2 marks also, why Laspierre's index number shows upward bias. So the answer is Laspierre's index is based on base year quantity, which gives relatively greater weightage for such commodities than needed. So it is giving more weightage to the lesser items. So because of that we have upward bias. Here it is giving lesser importance. In the Paget's index number, since we have the current year quantity, it is taken lesser importance is given there. So because of that we get downward bias. Marshall Edward, Darbish Bowley and Fisher's index number is free of bias because it uses both base year and current year price and quantity. So the next method are the problems based on this time reversal test and factor reversal test, which will be continuing in the next class. Thank you.